क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन। Today we are going to start quadratic equation, which is the very basic chapter of algebra, in fact of maths. You had studied this quadratic equation in 10th also, if you remember. But again, I will start from the very beginning. First of all, I will ask you, what is a polynomial? Polynomial function. If I will ask you, what is a polynomial function? Then you will say that a function f of x is equal to a naught x power n plus a 1 x power n minus 1 plus and so on up to a n is called a polynomial function, where a 1, a naught, a 1, a 2 and so on a n are real numbers and n is natural number. N is what, your natural number, then it is called a polynomial function. If a naught not equal to 0, if this coefficient a naught is not equal to 0, then we say that n is degree of f of x. Then what is this power n is called? Degree of the polynomial function, degree of f of x. Now if you remember, in particularly, if n is equal to 1, if n is equal to 1 means you will get f of x is equal to some ax plus b form. What you will get? F of x is, you see that highest power is what now? 1. And now this is only called your linear expression. Linear expression or linear function. Obviously, and a not equal to 0, then it will become linear. If a is 0, it will become constant. If a not equal to 0, this is called your linear expression or linear function. In particular, if n equal to 2, then what is your f of x? Can I say that ax square plus bx plus c? If a not equal to 0, then now tell me, what is the degree? 2. When degree is 2, then such an expression is called quadratic expression. For example, x square minus x plus 7 is a quadratic expression. 2x square minus 3x plus 4 is a quadratic expression. These are called your quadratic expression when highest power is what? 2. Now again, this is what, ax square plus bx plus c is a quadratic expression. When this expression equal to 0, when this expression is equal to 0, this is called quadratic equation. What is it called? Quadratic equation. And quadratic expression, when you will consider is equal to 0, this total is called your quadratic equation. Obviously, a not equal to 0. Why? If a is 0, it will never become quadratic, it will become linear. So most important thing is a should not be equal to 0. Then such an expression, ax square plus bx plus c, is called a quadratic expression. For example, x square minus x plus 7 equal to 0 is a quadratic equation. 2x square minus 3x plus 4 equal to 0 is a quadratic equation. X square minus 5x plus 6 equal to 0, quadratic equation. So this is a quadratic equation. If I will put x equal to 2, what you will get? LHS. 4 minus 10 plus 6. 4 minus 10 plus 6, is it equal to 0 or not? Yes. So LHS equal to RHS means I will say that the x equal to 2 satisfying that equation. For example, if I will put x equal to 1, what you will get? LHS. 1 minus 5 plus 6, which is equal to 2, not equal to 0. So I will say x equal to 2 satisfying the equation, but x equal to 1 not satisfying the equation. If I will put x equal to 0, what is your LHS become? 6, which is not equal to 0. So I will say that 0 is also not satisfying the equation. If I will put x equal to 3, what is LHS? What is LHS? 9 minus 15 plus 6. 15 minus 15, how much? 0. So this is also satisfying the equation. These two values are satisfying, these two values are not satisfying. The values which satisfies the equation are called roots of quadratic equation. What are they called? Roots of quadratic equation. The values which not satisfies the equation are not the roots of quadratic equation. So in particular, if for x square minus 5x plus 6 equal to 0, if I will ask the roots, what will say? 2 is a root and 3 is a root. 0 is not a root, 1 is not a root. Did you understand what is the meaning of root of the equation? Now suppose I will not take the equation, I will simply say that y equal to x square minus 5x plus 6. Now this is not equation, this is expression. X square minus 5x plus 6 equal 6 is the quadratic expression. Now at x equal to 2, this expression becomes 0 or not? So 2 is 0 of x square minus 5x plus 6. The value of x which makes the expression 0 are called zeros of the quadratic expression. And if quadratic equation is given, the value of x for which that quadratic equation satisfies is called root of the quadratic equation. What is it called? Root of quadratic equation. So in this case, we are taking some values and we are checking. How many values I took? 4. But actually, how many values we have to check for infinitely many values of x? Is it practically possible to check all the values of x, whether it is a root or not? Practically, it is not possible. Mean we have to find some formula or some method to find the roots of the quadratic equation. Now I will derive that formula, how to find the roots of quadratic equation. So, suppose ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 is the quadratic equation. What is the quadratic equation? Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. If it is a quadratic equation, a should not be equal to 0. Why? If a is 0, it will become linear. So, a not equal to 0. So, see that, can I write like this? This implies a into x square plus b by a into x plus c by a equal to 0. I took a common. Can I take? Of course. Why? Because a not equal to 0. Suppose a is 0, then can we take? No. Why? Denominator cannot be 0. If a is 0, this is coming in the denominator. If denominator is 0, the value is not defined. But here we can take because a not equal to 0. Now, what I will do is, I will try to make it a perfect square. So in perfect square formula, a plus b whole square or a minus b whole square, our formula is a square plus 2ab plus b square, a square minus 2ab plus b square. So anyhow, we need that 2. So that's why I'm multiplying and divide by 2. So far you got a square plus 2ab. See that, plus b square by 4a square minus b square by 4a square plus c by a equal to 0. Did you understand what I had done in this step? X square multiplying and dividing by 2. Can we do? See the 2 to cancel, you will get 1 only. Add and subtract b square by 4a square. Means I am adding 0. If you add 0, the expression will not change. Now this implies a into a square plus 2ab plus b square is a plus b whole square. A plus b whole square. Till here, first three terms. For these two, what is the LCM? 4a square. What is the LCM? 4a square. So what do you get here? Minus b square plus 4ac equal to 0. Have any doubt? So I will say that a into x plus b by 2a whole square plus 4ac minus b square by 4a equal to 0. Did you understand this step? Actually, I am opening the bracket with a, so that's why a into this here denominator is actually 4a square. But when we open the bracket with a, 1a will get cancelled. So this is a into x plus b by 2a whole square is equal to b square minus 4ac by 4a. Any doubt? This 4ac minus b square, when it will go in the right hand side with negative sign? Negative sign means b square minus 4ac. So x plus b by 2a whole square is equal to b square minus 4ac by 4a square, isn't it? This a I am bringing in the right hand side, 4a square. So I will say that x plus b by 2a is equal to plus or minus root over of b square minus 4ac by 2a. I hope you understand why this plus or minus coming. Because minus 2 square is also 2, plus 2 square is also 2. So when I will ask you what is root over of 4, it should be plus or minus 2. When you will take root over, plus or minus sign will come. So now I will send that minus b by 2a in the right hand side. X equal to minus b by 2a plus or minus root over of b square minus 4ac by 2a. What is LCM? 2a. What you will get in the numerator? Minus b plus or minus root over of b square minus 4ac. So when you will take plus sign, you will get one root. I am giving the name of that root as minus b plus root over of b square minus 4ac by 2a, taking plus sign. And when you will take minus sign, other root, I will give you the name as minus b minus root over of b square minus 4ac by 2a. These are the roots of quadratic equation. Write down. So now using this, you can easily find the equation or roots of any quadratic equation. For example, x square minus 5x plus 6 equal to 0 only. We had seen that the roots are 2 and 3 by substituting some values. Now we will find the values using the formula. So compare, what is a? 1. What is b? Minus 5. What is c? 6. So x is equal to formula minus b minus of minus plus 5 plus or minus root over of b square minus 4ac by 2a. This is the formula, no? Minus b plus or minus root over b square minus 4ac by 2a. So this is 5 plus or minus 25 minus 24, 1 by 2. So if you will take plus sign, 5 plus 1 by 2, if you will take minus sign, 5 minus 1 by 2, 5 plus 1, 6 by 2, 3, 5 minus 1, 4 by 2, 2, these are the roots. What are the roots? 3 and 2, these are the roots of quadratic equation. Like that, you can check now for any problem, you can find the root like this. Now, so for this equation we had calculated the root as x equal to minus b plus or minus root over of b square minus 4ac by 2a. This in the root over term is there, no? That is actually very, very important term. So that's why we will consider this as separately. What? B square minus 4ac. We will give this as some name d. Every time we will not write b square minus 4ac, we will simply say it is some d. This is called discriminant. What is it called? Discriminant of quadratic equation. Discriminant of quadratic equation. What? Ax square, sorry, b square minus 4ac is called discriminant of quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c. Now, roots of the quadratic equation completely depend upon this discriminant only, whether the roots are real or imaginary, everything depend upon this value of d only. What is this d? B square minus 4ac. Now, we will study the nature of the roots. Nature of roots. First one, if d greater than 0, if d greater than 0, then alpha equal to minus b plus root over of d by 2a, beta is equal to minus b minus root over of d by 2a. Now, if d is positive, so this root over will be defined. You know that if something in the root over is negative, then it is imaginary. But here, if d is greater than 0, this root over will define. So, this is a real quantity, this is also real quantity. But here, you are adding something in minus b, here you are subtracting something in minus b. So, these two values will be equal or different? Different, obviously different, different. But both the values are real. So, that is the conclusion that if d greater than 0, then roots are real and unequal. Roots are real and unequal. But now in this d greater than 0 only, two cases will arise. First one, A, if d is a perfect square, if d is a perfect square and a, b, c are rational numbers, if a, b, c are rational numbers and d is a perfect square, then you only tell me that d is perfect square, can I take d is some k square? Can I take d is some k square? Then see that alpha you will get minus b plus k by 2a and beta you will get minus b minus k by 2a. So, this total k is real, k is rational, b is rational, a is rational, means total value is rational. Here also this is rational, this is rational, this is rational, means total value is rational. So, here I am giving the conclusion that if a, b, c are rational and d is a perfect square, then roots are rational. Which type of roots you will get? Rational roots. Now, in this one only, second case, if ABC belongs to Q and D is not a perfect square, Q means set of all rational numbers, not a perfect square, then roots are irrational. Which type of roots you will get? Irrational, isn't it? You only see that alpha is equal to minus b plus root d by 2a. Can I write like this? Beta is minus b by 2a minus root d by 2a. Can I write the denominator? I am taking separately. So now observe that this is not a perfect square. So root over will always be there. Root over is there means it's an irrational term. Which type of term? Irrational term. So see carefully, can I write this alpha as p plus root q, where root q is root over of d by 4a square, can I say? And if alpha is p plus root q, what is your beta? P is what? Minus b by 2a. P minus root q. Did you understand this step? means I want to say that if a, b, c are rational numbers and d is not a perfect square, then roots are irrational and they exist in, they exists in conjugate pair. They exist in conjugate pair. Conjugate pair means if one root is of the form p plus root q, then other root will be p minus root q. Do you understand? If ABC is rational and D is a perfect square, then the roots will be rational. If ABC are rational and D is not a perfect square, then roots are irrational and they exist in conjugate pair. Conjugate pair means if P plus root Q is one root, P minus root Q will be another root. Means simply I want to say that if in equation has 2 plus root 3 as one root, no need to calculate other root. Directly it will be 2 minus root 3, no doubt at all. For example, suppose x square plus 2x minus 3 equal to 0. This is the quadratic equation, suppose. So I will ask you the root. X equal to minus b plus or minus root over of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So what is this? Minus 2 plus or minus. Can I take 4 out from the root over? It will come 2. 1 plus 3, 4. By 2. So what will you get? Minus 2 plus or minus 2 into 2, 4 by 2. 4 minus 2, 2 by 2, 1. Minus 4 minus 2, minus 6 by 2, minus 3. These are the roots. Now see that here 4, 3 is 12 plus 4, 16. 12 plus 4, 16. It's a perfect square, na? It's a perfect square. See, that's why the roots are, both the roots are rational, in particularly integer roots, but not necessarily always integer exist. Suppose, for example, if I will give like this 3, one more example we will do. Here, you observe one thing, that if discriminant is a perfect square, then roots will be rational. Now, I will give you an example where discriminant is not a perfect square. For example, suppose I will give 2x square plus 2x minus 3 equal to 0. Then what are the roots? X equal to minus b plus or minus root over of b square minus 4 a c by 2a. That is minus 2 plus or minus 4 will come out of the root 2. 1, 3, 2, 6 plus 1, 7 by 4. Did you understand this step? 4 out of the root, so out of the root 2 will come out. Here 1, 3, 2, 6, minus of minus plus, 1 plus 7. So, you will get here, minus 1 by 2 plus root 7 by 2, 1 root. And minus 1 by 2 minus root 7 by 2, another root. See that? There is the only change. This is same in both the roots. This is same in both the roots. Here plus sign, here minus sign. When, I think you had studied this in certs in lower classes, that if a plus root b is one irrational number, then a minus root b is called its conjugate. Had you studied this? If not, then from here onwards remember that. Means 2 plus root 3 is conjugate of 2 minus root 3, or 2 minus root 3 is conjugate of 2 plus root 3. They are conjugate of each other like this only. This root is conjugate of this, or this root is conjugate of this. Means whenever the irrational root exists, they exist only in the conjugate pairs. This is your second nature of the root. Nature of the roots, first thing we had studied, when discriminant greater than 0, roots are real and unequal. But in that also two cases exist, when discriminant is a perfect square and discriminant is not a perfect square. When discriminant is a perfect square, roots are real and rational when ABC are rational. And if ABC are rational and discriminant is not a perfect square, then roots are irrational and they exist in conjugate pair. Conjugate pair means if P plus root Q is one root, then other root will be P minus root Q. Next one, second condition, if d equal to 0, then come on, tell me, obviously for what equation we are considering? Ax square plus bx plus c. This is our fixed equation now, a naught equal to 0. Come on, tell me, what are the roots? X equal to my alpha first root minus b plus root d by 2a. Second root, beta equal to minus b plus root d by 2a, isn't it? But d is what? 0. So alpha will become minus b by 2a and beta will become minus b by 2a. Means, can we say that alpha equal to beta? Can we say alpha equal to beta? Means, here I want to say that if a quadratic equation is there whose coefficients are real and discriminant equal to 0, then roots will be real. Both the quantities are real because a and b are real and equal. So what you will give the conclusion? If d equal to 0, then roots are real and equal. Roots are real and equal. For example, if I will give the equation as 2x square plus 6x suppose this is the equation given, or suppose the equation is 4x square plus 12x minus 9 equal to 0. For example, suppose the equation is 4x square plus 12x minus 9 equal to 0. Then, what is the discriminant? B square. I will write here plus if you don't have any problem. B square minus 4ac. B square minus 4ac, 144, 16 nines, 144, 144 minus 144, 0. Discriminant is 0, means root should be real and equal. We will try to find. What is the equation? Roots, x equal to minus b plus or minus root over of b square minus 4ac means d, which we got 0, by 2a. So what are the roots? Minus 6 by 4, that is minus 3 by 2, plus 0 or minus 0 doesn't matter, both will come same only. Did you understand this point? Now if you observe in other way, see that how I am writing. I will write this as 2x whole square plus 2 into 2x into 3. Check it, 3 to 6 to 12 plus 9 equal to 0. Is this point is clear to you how I am writing the expression? 2x whole square plus 2 into 2x into 3 plus, can I write this 9 as 3 square? Can you tell me why I am writing like this? I want to say that it is a square plus 2ab plus b square equal to 0. A square plus 2ab plus b square equal to 0 means a plus b equal to 0. Now you want to tell me that when a perfect square is 0, when that particular value should be 0 or x equal to minus 3 by 2, this is only the root of this equation. Write down. Now in the nature of the root, before going to the next condition, I want to give you a small concept of imaginary numbers. Then we will go to that one, imaginary number. Now, can you tell me a number which multiplied by itself give you a negative number? Suppose x is some 2 I will take. So 2 into 2, 4, is it negative? No. If I will take x equal to 0, 0 into 0 is how much? 0. Is it negative? No. If I will take x equal to minus 2, then minus 2 into minus 2 is how much? 4. Is it negative? No. Means here I took 3 examples because I want to check whether for positive number it will satisfy. No. If 2 is positive number, positive into positive is positive. If for 0, is it satisfying? No. 0 into 0 is 0. Does it satisfy for negative? No. If you multiply a negative number with itself, you will get a positive of that square. See that minus 2 is what? 4. Means I want to say that in real number, there is a no number whose square is negative. There is no real number whose square is negative. Now, since there is no real number which satisfies this thing, that's why the next concept of imaginary number has been introduced. Means, suppose this iota does not exist in real number. Suppose iota is a number which when multiplied by itself will give you minus 1. Iota is a number which when multiplied by itself will give you minus 1. Now, is there any such iota in real number? No. That's why this iota is called your imaginary number. What is it called? Imaginary number. So, I square is what? Root over of? I square is what? I square is minus 1. So, what is your I? Root over of minus 1. I is what? Root over of minus 1. This is called imaginary number. What is it called? Imaginary number. Suppose if you have to find root over of minus 3, you should write this as root 3 into root over of minus 1. That is root 3 into root over of minus 1 is what? Iota. That is root over of minus 3 is what? Root 3 iota. Suppose you have to find root over of minus 4. You should write this as root over of 4 into root over of minus 1. Root over of 4 is 2 and root over of minus 1 is iota. Means what is root over of minus 4? 2 iota. You should remember this. Then some more properties. Then we will go to the next nature of the root. So, what I want to say here is, suppose if a and b are real numbers, then I think you know this property that root over of a into root over of b is what? Root over of ab. Do you know this property? Yes. Now, I will say that root over of minus a into root over of b is root over of minus ab. This also I will prove. Then if I will ask you what is root over of minus a into root over of minus b, you can say like that root over of minus a into root over of minus b, that is root over of ab. That is root over of ab. Root over of ab. But I will prove that this is actually wrong. First we will come here that how is it possible. So root over of minus a into root over of b, can I write this as root over of minus 1 into root a into root b? That is, you know that now, this property is there in real numbers. Root a into root b is root over of ab into iota. But root over of ab into iota, we can write as minus of root over of minus of ab. So, we got root over of ab into iota, that is root over of minus ab. So, this is true. But if I will discuss about this, what? Root over of minus a into root over of minus b. According to the definition, we should write this as root over of a into iota into root over of b into iota. Can we write according to the definition? Now you know that root over of a into root over of b is root over of ab into iota, iota square. Now see the definition of iota. What is iota square? Minus 1. So what you'll get? Minus of root over of ab. So root over of minus a into root over of minus b is minus of root over of ab. Be careful, many will do this mistake, but I hope you will not do. This is very important thing. Okay, so root over of minus a into root over of minus b is minus of root over of ab. So, that is about imaginary number. Now, if A and B are real numbers, A and B are real numbers, then any number of the form A plus IB, where I is what? Root over of minus 1, is called a complex number. What is it called? A complex number. which you'll study in detail in complex number chapter. But here I am giving you this discussion because in the next type I need this. So that's why I am giving a very basic introduction of imaginary number and complex number. See that a number of the form a plus ib, where I equal to root over of minus 1, is called a complex number. And if a plus ib is a complex number, then a minus ib means what? See that if a plus ib is a number, this is called real part. What is it called? Real part. This b is called imaginary part. What is it called? Imaginary part. Why? Because this b coefficient is iota, which is an imaginary number. So that's why it is called an imaginary part. Now if complex number is a plus ib, then if you change the sign of the negative part, if you will get a minus ib. This a minus ib is called conjugate of a minus ib is called conjugate of a plus ib. What is it called? Conjugate of a plus ib. As you had seen in real, what irrational numbers, na? If a plus root b is a irrational number, then a minus root b is called its conjugate. Like that only, if a plus ib is a complex number, then a minus ib is called the conjugate of that complex number. This much discussion is enough for now. You will study all these things in detail in complex number chapter. So now our third case will come, case 3. What? Case 3, what if d is less than 0? We had already discussed the case when d greater than 0. We had discussed the case when d equal to 0. Now we are discussing the case when d, which is discriminant, is less than 0. Now if d is less than 0, suppose d is equal to some minus k, where k greater than 0. D is equal to minus k, where k is greater than 0. Then you only tell me that what is your alpha? Minus b plus root d by 2a, beta minus b minus root d by 2a, isn't it? So alpha is equal to minus b plus root d is what? Root over of minus k. Root over of minus k by 2a. Beta is what? Minus b minus root over of minus k by 2a. Now can I write this as minus b by 2a plus k by 2a into iota? See that root over of minus k, k iota, where k is positive since. Okay. And what about beta? Minus b by 2a minus root over of k by 2a iota. Can I write? So now see that alpha and beta, this is same as this. This is same as, I think, root over, na? Yeah. This is same as this. Only the change is there in plus and minus. So can I say that if d less than 0, then roots are imaginary or complex number. Roots are complex or roots are imaginary, and they exist in conjugate pair. They exist in conjugate pair. That is, if p plus iota q is one root, other root will be p minus iota q. P minus iota q. For example, suppose I will take x square plus x minus plus 4 equal to 0 as a quadratic equation. So if I will ask you his roots, minus b plus or minus root over of b square minus 4ac by 2a. That is minus 1 by 2 plus or minus root over of 15 with negative sign. Na? So can I say 15 iota by 2? So what is the first root? Minus 1 by 2 plus 15 by root 2, 15 by 2 iota, minus 1 by 2 minus root 15 by 2 iota. These are the two roots. Since iota is there, means roots are imaginary. See that plus sign one root, minus sign other root, means they are existing in conjugate pairs. Write down. Next. Write down a problem. Find the values of the parameter A. Find the values of the parameter A for which the quadratic equation Find the value of the parameter A for which the quadratic equation A plus 1 into x square plus twice of A plus 1 into x plus A minus 2 equal to 0 has first condition two distinct roots. Two distinct roots. Second condition has no roots. Third condition has two equal roots. Has two equal roots. See that, don't get confused. Every quadratic equation has the roots, but here has no roots means his means this no real roots. His means no real roots means imaginary roots can be there. No roots means no real roots. So come on, tell me, two distinct roots or no real root or equal root, all these things depends upon discriminant. So can you tell me what is the discriminant? D equal to b square minus 4ac. B square minus 4ac, which is what? Can you take 4 common? 2 square 4, here also 4. What do you get inside? A square plus 2a plus 1 minus a square. Achha, one thing I will do, I will keep the bracket so that you will not get confused. A square minus 2a plus a minus 2. Is it clear to you? First of all, here 2 square 4, 4 out, a plus 1 whole square, a square plus 2a plus 1 minus of a square minus 2a plus a minus 2. That is 4 times of a square plus 2a plus 1 minus a square minus 2a plus a minus a minus of minus plus a plus 2. A square cancel. That is 4 times of 2a plus a 3a plus 3, that is, can I say that 12 times of a plus 1 is your discriminant? This is your discriminant. So if d greater than 0, you know that roots are real and unequal, which is the first case. Two distinct roots. Distinct roots means real and unequal. So discriminant should be greater than 0, means 12 times of a plus 1 should be greater than 0. This is possible when a is greater than minus 1. So when a is greater than minus 1, you have two distinct roots. Now his second condition, he says that no real root. No real root means, no real root means d should be less than 0, means 12 times of a plus 1 should be less than 0, means a should be less than minus 1. A should be greater than minus 1 for unequal roots. First condition, distinct roots. No real roots when a is less than minus 1. And what is the third condition he asked? Third condition for equal roots. For equal roots, your d should be equal to 0, means 12 times of a plus 1 equal to 0, means a should be equal to minus 1. This is the value of a when the equation has two equal roots. Write down. next problem. Next problem. Solve for x. Solve for x. Solve for x. See very carefully. This is the problem which asked in one of the IIT exam. Very basic problem, but very good problem. Listen very carefully. Solution. We have to solve. Solve means you have to find the values of x. So come on, tell me, what is 5 plus 2 root 6 into 5 minus 2 root 6? First of all, I am considering something. 5 plus 2 root 6 into 5 minus 2 root 6 is 5 square 25. Minus 4 into 6. 6 4 is 24. 25 minus 24, how much? 1. How much? 1. So can I say that 5 minus 2 root 6 is equal to 1 by 5 plus 2 root 6? Have any problem? 5 plus 2 root 6 into 5 minus 2 root 6 is 1. So 5 minus 2 root 6 is 1 by 5 plus 2 root 6. If you don't have any problem in this step, I will proceed further. Have any confusion? No. So suppose 5 plus 2 root 6 power x square minus 3 is t. So can I say that 5 minus 2 root 6 power x square minus 3 is 1 by t? Agreed? Just now we had proved that, na? 5 minus 2 root 6 is the reciprocal of 5 plus 2 root 6. So this value will be reciprocal of this. Now substitute these values in the given equation. What will you get? T plus 1 by t is what? 10. T plus 1 by t is what? 10. So t square plus 1 is equal to 10t. LCM t. T square plus 1 is equal to what? 10t. So t square minus 10t plus 1 equal to 0. This 10t I am bringing in the left hand side. What you will get? A quadratic in t. Can you find its roots? Now you will find the roots of this quadratic equation. Come on, tell me. T is equal to formula minus b. So minus of minus 10 plus 10 plus or minus root over of b square 100 minus 4ac by 2a. Have any doubt? Minus b plus or minus root over b square minus 4ac by 2a. That is 10 plus or minus 100 minus 4, 96 by 2. Or can we say that 10 plus or minus root over of 16, 6 is the 96, na? 2. Or can we say that 10 plus or minus 4 root 6 by 2. Are you following? 16, root over of 16 is 4, root 6 is as it is. Or can I say that this is equal to 5 plus or minus 2 root 6? These are the values of t. So if you will take t equal to, first I will take plus sign, then I will take minus sign. T equal to 5 plus 2 root 6. But t is what actually? 5 plus 2 root 6 power x square minus 3. If you remember, this only is our assumption that 5 plus 2 root 6 power x square minus 3 is t. So this is equal to 5 plus 2 root 6. Can I say it's power 1? See that the base are same. Powers must be equal. So x square minus 3 is 1. So x square is 4. So can I say that x is equal to plus or minus 2? Have any problem? This is one case when we are taking here plus sign. Now if I will take t equal to 5 minus 2 root 6. But t is what? 5 plus 2 root 6 whole power x square minus 3. And can I write this as 5 plus 2 root 6 power minus 1? Check it, remembered or not? 5 minus 2 root 6 into 5 plus 2 root 6 is 1. So 5 minus 2 root 6 is the reciprocal of 5 plus 2 root 6. So can I say that x square minus 3 is minus 1? So x square is minus 3 when you are there, 3. Minus 1, 2. So x equal to plus or minus root 2. So what are the roots? Minus 2, 2, minus root 2 and root 2. These are your solutions. Write down. A very good problem. Next heading is relation between roots. Relation between the roots. So come on, tell me. Suppose ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 is the quadratic equation a not equal to 0 whose roots are? Roots are alpha and beta. What are the roots? Alpha and beta. Then you only tell me that. What is alpha? Minus b plus root over of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Is it alpha or not? And what is beta? Minus b minus root over of b square minus 4ac by 2a. This is your beta. Then come on, tell me, sum of roots, sum of roots, alpha plus beta is equal to minus b plus root over of b square minus 4ac by 2a plus minus b minus root over of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So what is LCM? 2a. What do you get in the numerator? Minus b plus root over of b square minus 4ac minus b minus root over of b square minus 4ac, isn't it? Root over of b square minus 4ac, root over of b square minus 4ac will get cancelled. Minus b minus b minus 2b by 2a, 2 cancel. What you'll get? Minus b by a. This is the formula, sum of roots, sum of roots, alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. Now this you have to remember, that sum of the root is, or you should remember in other words like this. What? Coefficient minus of coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. So, next is product of the roots. Next is what? Product of roots. What is the product? Alpha into beta. What is the product? Alpha into beta. What is alpha? Minus b plus root over of b square minus 4ac by 2a into minus b minus root over of b square minus 4ac by 2a. 2a into 2a, denominator 4a square, numerator a plus b into a minus b, a plus b into a minus b, a square minus b square. So if you open the bracket, this is minus b whole square is b square, minus b square plus 4ac by 4a square. B square cancel, you will get 4ac by 4 a square, 4 4 cancel, a cancel, this is how much, c by a, this is your product of roots, what, alpha into beta is equal to c by a, alpha into beta is what, c by a, how you'll remember this, coefficient, constant term by, constant by coefficient of x square, this is your product of the roots, write down, sum of the roots, product of the root, these two formulae you must remember. Sum of the roots and product of the roots. Now listen very carefully. See very carefully. Let alpha comma beta be the roots of ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Then just now we had proved that alpha plus beta is what? Minus b by a, and alpha into beta is what? C by a, obviously a not equal to 0. Now see very carefully what I am writing. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to a, if I will take common, x square plus b by a into x plus c by a. Is this step is clear to you? So this is a into x square. Come on, tell me, what is b by a? Can I write minus of alpha plus beta into x? Can I write? Plus what is c by a? Alpha into beta. Can I write? Can I write? Now just see that what we had proved just now, that ax square plus bx plus c can be equal to minus a into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. So come on, tell me, if ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, using this, can I write as a into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha into beta equal to 0? Can I write? Now you observe that product of these two terms is 0, means either first one 0 or second one 0, but a is not equal to 0, means this second should be 0, means you got x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta equal to 0. You got this from here only, means can I say that this is this quadratic equation only? Now see that this is the formula to find the quadratic equation when roots are given. How you will say that? X square minus sum of the roots, sum of the roots into x plus product of roots equal to 0 is your required quadratic equation. If you know the roots, you can find the equation. How? X square minus sum of the roots into x plus product of the roots equal to 0. For example, if I will ask you that find the equation whose roots are 2 and minus 7, whose roots are 2 and minus 7. So this is your alpha, this is your beta. What is alpha plus beta? Minus 5. What is alpha into beta? Minus 14. So equation become x square minus sum of the roots into x. Did you understand? X square minus sum of the roots into x plus product of the roots equal to 0, or x square plus 5x minus 14 equal to 0. This is your required quadratic equation. Now if you want to confirm, just try to find the roots of this equation using the formula method. You will get these only as the roots. One more example, suppose find the equation whose roots are 1 by 2 and 1 by 3. Then come on, tell me, what is alpha plus beta? 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3, that is 5 by 6. What is alpha into beta? 1 by 2 into 1 by 3, that is 1 by 6. So equation will become x square minus sum of the roots into x plus product of the roots equal to 0, that is 6x square minus 5x plus 1 equal to 0. This is the method. If you have the roots, you can find the equation. Write down. Then see, very important next one, factorization method means to find the roots of the equation, there are two methods. One is formula method, which already I gave. If the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, then its roots are given by minus b plus or minus root over of b square minus 4ac by 2a. That is called your factorization method. Now, which method? Formula method. Now, we will try to find the roots using factorization method. Then, let alpha comma beta be the roots of this equation. Then, can we write alpha plus beta is minus b by a into alpha into beta is c by a? So again, see that ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. So can I say this as a into x square plus b by a into x plus c by a equal to 0? Or can I say a into x square minus of alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta equal to 0. Observe very carefully what is the left hand side is going on, that you should also remember. Now, this is a into x square minus alpha x minus beta x plus alpha beta equal to 0, or a into x, if you will take common, x minus alpha minus beta, if you will take common, x minus alpha equal to 0. That is a into, from the both, if you will take x minus alpha common, you will get x minus beta equal to 0. Till here, any confusion? Now, if you observe that so far, what is the left hand side actually running? Ax square plus bx plus c, that is the left hand side running, which just now I proved is equal to a into x minus alpha into x minus beta. This is nothing but what we had done, the factorization. Now, this also you should remember, very useful. Ax square plus bx plus c is equal to a into x minus alpha into x minus beta if alpha comma beta are the roots of ax square plus bx plus c. Now, see from here, what we had proved, a into x minus alpha into x minus beta equal to 0. Come on, tell me, can a be 0? No. This is non-zero, so these two should, product is 0 means x minus alpha equal to 0 or x minus beta equal to 0, or sometimes maybe both equal to 0. X minus alpha is 0 means x is what? Alpha. X minus beta is 0 means what? X equal to beta. See that, like this also you can find the root. This is called your factorization method by splitting the middle term. I hope you remember, you had studied this in 10th. How you will split the middle term? You should split the middle term in such a way that sum of the middle term should be the middle term and the product should be the product of first and last. Like that, you have to break the middle term. First write down this, then I will do some problems based on this. For example, just the very first one only, just I had proved, if you remember, that x square minus 5x plus 6. First I had proved that the roots are 2 and 3. If you remember, very beginning of the class, I took some value 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and I proved that 2 and 3 are the root. Then for the same equation, I proved that the roots are 2 and 3 using the formula, if you remember. Now see that this splitting the middle term and factorization, this one I will prove. Okay. So come on, tell me, what is the product of the first and last term? 6. What is the product? 6. And what is the middle coefficient? Minus 5. I want to say that divide minus 5 in such a way that its product should be 6 and sum should be minus 5. So see that how I am writing. X square minus plus minus 2x minus 3x plus 6 equal to 0. See that. What is the product? Minus 2 into minus 3. 6 is coming or not? Yes. And minus 2 minus 3 is how much? Minus 5. So both the condition is satisfying. Sum is minus 5 and product is how much? 6. Now if you will take x common, what you'll get? Into x minus 2. If you will take minus 3 common, what you'll get? Into x minus 2 equal to 0. From this, what you can take common? X minus 2. What left inside? X minus 3 equal to 0. Again, product of these two is 0. So x minus 2 equal to 0. X minus 3 equal to 0. So x is equal to 2 comma 3, which are the roots of the equation. First direct substitution method, then formula method. Now splitting the middle term and finding the value. Is it clear to you? So like that, you can, if the roots are directly existing, some integral roots or rational roots, it is always preferable to follow this method only. Which method? Splitting the middle term. One more example. Six x square plus 5x plus 1 equal to 0. See that I will write this as 6x square plus 2 plus 3, 5 na? Plus 1 equal to 0. See that 3 into 2, product of first and last. These two sum, 5. What you can take common here? 2x. What left? 3x plus 1. Plus of 3x plus 1 equal to 0. From the both, what you can take common? 3x plus 1. What left inside? 2x plus 1. So if you will take second one 0, you will get x equal to minus 1 by 2. If you will take first one 0, you will get x equal to minus 1 by 3. These are the roots. Using which method? Again, factorization method. Now see that some symmetric relations between the roots. See very carefully. Let alpha comma beta be the roots of ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Then you know that what is the sum of the roots? Minus b by a. What is the product of the roots? C by a. These things we had already seen, that sum of the roots is minus b by a and product of the roots is c by a. Now using this only, we will derive now few more things, in which first one is difference of roots. Difference of roots. Alpha minus beta. I will take mod. Alpha minus beta. Can I write this as root over of alpha minus beta whole square? See that square, square root cancel, you get this only. Why I am taking mod of alpha minus beta means I want to say that bigger root minus smaller root. If alpha is bigger, you should write alpha minus beta. If beta is bigger, you should write beta minus alpha. Nothing more than that. This quantity we want positive, that's why. Can I write like this? Yes, I can. So this is nothing but, observe that, you know that a minus b whole square is equal to a plus b whole square minus 4ab. Did you remember this? Have you studied this formula that a minus b whole square is root over of a plus b whole square minus 4ab? Now this is root over of, what is alpha plus beta? Minus b by a square means, can I write b square by a square? Have any problem? B square by a square minus 4 times of alpha into beta c by a. What is the LCM? a square. What do you get in the numerator? B square minus 4ac. Check it. B square minus 4ac. So can I write this as rootor of d by a? Can I write this as rootor of d by a? See that b square minus 4ac. If you remember, that is the discriminant. So rootor of d by a. This is the formula to find the difference of the roots. What? Difference of the roots. Next one, second one, we will calculate now what is alpha square plus beta square. What is alpha square plus beta square? Can I write this as alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta? A plus B whole square minus 2AB is A square plus B square. What is alpha plus beta? Minus B by A. It's a square minus 2. Alpha into beta C by A. That is, what is the LCM? A square. What do you get? B square minus 2AC by A square is the formula for alpha square plus beta square. Next one will come alpha square minus beta square. Alpha square minus beta square, can I write as alpha minus beta into alpha plus beta? You know that alpha plus beta is minus b by a and alpha into beta is root d by mod a, isn't it? So this is the formula for alpha square. Just now we had derived alpha minus beta, that I am putting alpha plus beta already you know. So that we got here. Next formula is alpha cube plus beta cube. Can I write alpha cube plus beta cube as alpha plus beta whole cube minus 3 alpha beta into alpha plus beta a cube plus b cube, a plus b whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b, which is alpha plus beta minus b by its cube minus b cube by a cube minus 3 times of alpha into beta c by a, alpha plus beta minus b by a. Any problem? That is, what is the LCM? A cube. So minus b cube plus 3abc, because LCM is a cube, so 1a will go in the numerator. This is the formula for alpha cube plus beta cube. Can you similarly find for alpha cube minus beta cube? Alpha cube minus beta cube will be alpha minus beta whole cube plus 3 alpha beta into alpha minus beta. What is alpha minus beta? Rootor of d by a. So rootor of d by mod a whole cube plus 3 c by a into rootor of d by a. You can leave like this, or if you want you can further simplify this. So these are some of the symmetric relations. I want that you should calculate for try to calculate for alpha power 4 plus beta power 4 and alpha power 4 minus beta power 4. This is your work. I had done for alpha plus beta given, alpha into beta given, alpha minus beta I had calculated, alpha square plus beta square calculated, alpha square minus beta square calculated, alpha cube plus beta cube calculated, alpha cube minus beta cube calculated. If you understand all these cases, you can try for alpha power 4 plus beta power 4 and alpha power 4 minus beta power 4. This at least you can do today. Tomorrow, next class, we will do some more problem based on this, and we will study the condition for common roots in the next class.